Welcome to Truckee Talks. I'm your host, Maya Schneider. And on today's show, we're interviewing a guy that's been around a long time helping this community out. It's my pleasure to introduce you to Steve Randall. Steve, nice to have you on the show.
Thanks.
Now, Steve, you're known in the community as the guy who makes events happen, but you've got a day job, and your day job is managing the Reckon Park District.
That's correct.
How long have you been doing that?
17 years.
17 years.
17 great years.
There you go. But in addition to managing the Reckon Park District, and we'll talk about that in a while, you're really involved in the community. You gave me a list of some of the things you do. I did some checking as well. I look at the list of things that you've belonged to, the Rotary Club, the different events you volunteer for. Do you have time to eat?
Look at me. I have plenty of time to eat.
You make some time. Well, Steve, let's start at the beginning. Let's get a little bit of your background and find out a little bit more about who you are. Where are you from originally?
Originally, I'm from San Francisco. That's where I was born and raised in the Sunset District. Went to high school in San Francisco. Did my college at San Francisco State with a bachelor's and a master's. And then right out of college, started working for the city of Sausalito. Was able to, was the first park and rec director they ever had. So I was lucky I got to create the department. And was there for 10 years. And then I moved on to Truckee.
Yeah, you were the first park and rec director for the city of Sausalito.
Yes.
What was that, 1928? It had been a while ago.
Not quite. 75.
Where did you go to high school in San Francisco? We got to get that on the table.
To Lincoln.
Yeah, all right.
Lincoln High School.
Okay, well, I just want you to know that my high school team always beat your high school team at football in San Francisco.
Not in my era, maybe in yours.
Well, my high school didn't exist in your era.
That's possibly true. But, you know, it's kind of funny because when I did come to Truckee, I originally came here with the intent of staying 2 years. And it's now been 17 years later. This was going to be strictly just a stepping stone job and then back to the big city and that type of stuff. But I fell in love with the community. I love it up here. And 17 years, I'm still here. And I couldn't be happier.
Well, what drew you here originally 17 years ago? Why Truckee?
A job.
Now, that's the reverse of most people who leave a great job to come here. You found a job to come here.
Yeah. Well, I had a good job where I was, but I just threw in an application for this job in Truckee, not expecting to get it or even wanting to get it. And for some reason, you know, they picked me. And, you know, I went through some consternation on, you know, should I come here? Shouldn't I? Talk to my friends, and they said, you're going where? You know, it snows in Truckee. It's cold there all the time. And I said, well, yeah, I can do anything for a couple of years, and that's kind of how I got here.
17 years ago.
Yeah.
Steve, you've got a lovely wife, Susan.
Yes.
And three daughters.
Three beautiful daughters.
Do you ever feel outnumbered in your house?
Always. Including the dog is female, the rats are female, and I don't know the sexes of the fish, but I wouldn't be surprised.
You haven't reached in and turned the fish over.
No, but I'm sure they're probably females too.
Well, you're sort of outnumbered. Yes. Where do you go to hang with the guys?
Well, I get to go play my sports at night, so that helps.
There you go. Get a little balance.
Yep.
Well, you're in charge of recreation for the town of Truckee. Now, the community is...
Not for the town of Truckee.
Not just for the town of Truckee, right, actually.
For the Recreation and Park District.
District, yes. Which encompasses...
Which encompasses the town.
And?
And Russell Valley and Floriston and some parts of Donner Summit.
Okay, so you've got a bigger area than just the geographic boundaries of the town. This is, by its nature, a recreational area. People come here to play. They come here to mountain bike or to ski or to golf. So what are you doing to serve the local community? What do folks do with the Reckon Park District here?
Well, what we try to do is provide programs and activities for, you know, the things that they can't get on their own. You know, in a lot of ways, Truckee's an island. and, you know, we're centered by things. And so if people want certain recreational pursuits, they need to go to a place like a park and rec agency. But so we have classes for kids, we've got sports for kids, we've got sports for adults, we've got after school programs, myriad of special events such as this weekend coming up, the Easter egg hunt, lots of the haunted house, you know, I can go on and on. We have lots of facilities that we're trying to provide, special facilities, that type of thing. So anything that they can't get elsewhere, we try to provide on a recreational and park nature.
So when you came here 17 years ago, what was being offered to the community?
When I first came, I was actually the second park and rec director for the town. The first one had been here about 20 years, and he created a lot of facilities in the community, but there really wasn't much in the way of recreation, and that was really my charge. Recreation's a big thing, so, you know, as an example, when I first came, I think we had 3 youth basketball teams, and I think this last year we had 27 or 28. You know, we didn't have girls softball that's coming up in the springtime, things like that. So my original charge was to get lots of programs, lots of activities for all age groups in the community, and so that's what we've been able to accomplish.
Well, you've accomplished a lot in your 17 years, and most recently the accomplishment that comes to mind is the construction of the ice skating rink, which has been hugely popular. Mm-hmm. And one of our very favorite camera people and Channel 6 volunteers went out to the skate rink and interviewed a couple of your guys about the construction of that. So if we can get that film rolling, we'll show you this interview of how the skate rink came to be. Or we'll sit here and be quiet for a minute.
Hi, I'm Bob Bolton. I'm the park superintendent with Truckee Donner Rec and Park District. And I want to welcome you to the future home of the Truckee Ice Rink. About a year ago, we came up with the idea to put in an outdoor ice rink. I know there's a lot of support from the public to have an ice rink here in Truckee that's affordable for the community. We cannot afford an outdoor or an indoor one, so for now we decided we'd like to try one outdoors.
Hi, I'm Al Barclay, maintenance lead man at the Parks Department here in Truckee. We're in the process of developing hopefully this is the beginning of many years of a ice rink at the regional park in Truckee. This was originally an ice rink. We had, if you'd ever been out to the basketball court at the regional park, you'd notice there was a curb around it. It was originally meant to be an ice rink. It always depended on the weather we had as to whether we could make ice or not, whether it was a warm year or a year of a lot of snow. What we really needed was a dry year with lots of cold temperatures. So it's been real hard to make ice. This year we're going to attempt to make our own ice with a machine. This basketball court will be covered with 1.25 inch tubing, about 4 inches apart all the way across. It'll get a coating of sand just over the top of the tubes, and then we'll try to build ice on top of that. In the back we have a cooling unit that we bought from a company in Canada. It's a second-hand unit, but it's a cooler that was made for making ice rinks.
Well, Steve, that was a great tour of the facility, and here we get to see a little bit more of it, the construction of the skating rink. How do you feel about that? How has the reaction been in the community?
The reaction has been fantastic. People, during the wintertime, we've now since closed the rink because we're getting into spring, but I was stopped at the store. This is the greatest thing, you know, Truckee's ever done. It was just really a neat feeling. And I have to say, you know, I've been involved in building a lot of facilities, and I used to think that when we built the skateboard park that was probably the most instant gratification. I think this is the most instant gratification that I've gotten on anything I've ever done in the community. And, you know, I have to, you know, give my hats off to my staff because
they
made it work.
Yeah.
I might have been the idea man, but they were the one that was out that were out there putting it all together and making it work. And every day we learned as we went along, and it was not only the park staff but the recreation staff too. You know, Truckee is really fortunate to have the staff that we have at Parks and Recreation because they can take ideas, they make things work, and
it
happens. You know, I can say that within our community versus other communities, you know, when I go to state conferences and things like that, they're amazed at the things we do.
Well, frankly, I'm often amazed at the services that are offered by the district here in such a small area. Now, here we get to see the final product, and I've been out there a few times myself. It's actually been fun. I didn't grow up skating because, like you, I grew up in San Francisco, although there was the skate rink out in the avenues where you grew up.
Right.
This was really my first foray into ice skating,
And there you are.
And there I am freezing my hands off. But
and there you are again.
I'd really like to thank Jack Davis for including this clip in the video. If people don't understand at home, I have absolutely no control about what these guys put on the clips that we show here. But you just see families out there.
Yeah, you can see the little kids out there.
Yeah.
So what we tried to create was something that was for everybody. We wanted to make it affordable, so you know, we charge $2 a person to go, which should be affordable to everybody in the community. And then people from outside the community, we charged them $5 because they're not the ones that are supporting this community and doing things. So.
And the Zamboni. What would a skate rink be without the Zamboni? Or the Zamboni wannabe in that case.
There you go.
that's a wonderful thing, Stephen. Congratulations.
Well, thank you.
I think the community was just thrilled. Yeah. We saw a lot of people go out.
We were real pleased with it.
You've faced some challenges professionally. You've faced some challenges personally. You're a cancer survivor.
That's correct.
Tell us about that.
Well, when I turned 40, I was having some stomach problems and finally went to the doctor and anyway, ended up at the stomach doctor down in Reno and they took me in to do a colonoscopy and at 8 in the morning at 10 o'clock they told me I had cancer that was about the size of my fist. They operated that day and in fact at the time my wife was 8 months pregnant and they told her that I had a 25% chance of living. And I told them at that time, don't worry, I have 9 lives and I've only used 4 and here I am
so
today.
So that was one more.
That was one more, so I'm probably on 5 now. But
so you only have 4 left.
Yeah, so and that was 9 years ago, so it's been 9 years ago, actually last week. So
oh, that's, congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
That's a great thing. It's great to still have you around and 3 children later.
It's nice it's okay. Nice to be around.
Yeah. Well, and speaking of around here, Mr. Going on 50 next month.
That's true.
All right. So is the town throwing a parade in honor of your 50th birthday?
No, it'll be a nice, quiet event.
Oh, that's what you think.
Which I will celebrate with my, celebrate the joy of my family.
Susan, you better take him out of town if you're going to make that happen. Well, congratulations. Congratulations on making it to your 50th. You've really had some extraordinary experiences. Getting back into the personal realm, Steve, you've been in Truckee 17 years, but before you arrived here and before you settled into a family, you did some significant traveling.
Yeah, I used to, one of the things that I did, I was a travel agent on the side and used to do outside sales because I love to travel. Haven't done a lot recently since I started a family, but prior to that, I've got 64 countries and 5 continents, and I used to take a major trip every year and just go to different places. And being a travel agent, it afforded me to get anywhere from 50 to 80% off on all my travel, which made it affordable. So I've had some really neat experiences, been on safari in Africa, Galapagos Islands, into Indonesia, Red China. Got to go into Red China about just a couple months after it opened, and Soviet Union about 6 months after it opened. So I've been pretty lucky.
You make your own luck, Steve. I think you've managed to do all those things. If you could plan the next trip, where would it be?
The Antarctic.
Okay. Why? you live in the Antarctic, Steve.
Well, because I haven't been there, and it's kind of untamed country, and I like something different and new.
Will you be bringing your skate rink skates with you?
I don't know. Maybe.
What's next for Steve Randall?
I don't know. I mean, to be honest with you, it's, you know, I've got a great family, I have a great wife, great kids. I've got one of the best jobs in town. I mean, I honestly, I can't say that I could ask for anything more. It's just, You know, life goes on. It's wonderful. It's just great to be in a community like this where everybody's ready to pitch in and help out. And, you know, Truckee's a real community. It's not like some of these other places where, you know, people just come home, go to the job, you know, work. People in this community get involved, and that's really neat to see. I mean, someone needs help, they help out. And I think I'm here to stay for a while.
I think that's interesting. People have asked me when I say, well, Truckee's a community as opposed to X, Y, or Z places I've lived. And people say, well, define that. And I think you just did. It's getting involved, being involved. And you have 3 pages worth of involvement here on the things that you've accomplished. What have been some of the fun things you've really enjoyed working on as a volunteer?
I think probably, well, the first thing that I did when I came to the community was create the 4th of July celebration, and that was something that I had been doing in Sausalito, and I came here, and Truckee kind of had one of the local service clubs was doing a little tiny steak dinner at the regional park, and the chamber was doing the parade, and the downtown merchants had started doing a small fireworks show at the beach, and it was my idea just to create it all together and create a network to provide that. And so for 6 years we did the 4th of July as just, you know, volunteers, and before we turned it over to the Chamber of Commerce, you know, we used to get, you know, 5,000-6,000 people at the beach, you know, and the nature of the event was, it was a family event. Mm-hmm. And you'd go down there and it was kind of the signaling of winter being over, and you'd walk up and down the beach and everybody would see all their friends, and it was kind of a neat event. We lost that event a couple years ago, and last year I said, you know, it's time to bring it back, and that's what we did. And so last year we had, oh, probably about 5,000 plus at the beach, and plan to keep doing it again, but keep it with the family nature. And what we changed last year was you can't buy tickets into the beach unless you can show a local ID.
Right.
And so what we wanted to do with it is bring it back to the people. You know, Truckee deserves some of their own signature events, and this is what we're trying to do with it now.
How did it feel bringing it back to the West End Beach?
It was great. Yeah. You know, it everybody pitched in to help work. Rotary came in and sold food, and, you know, as a, you know, not to make money, but just to provide a service to the community. We did the games, and it was just a wonderful day for the community where they could just get together and, you know, have fun with their friends, and just a nice family day.
Well, and another event that you don't take much credit for, but would not have happened without you, is the Truckee Town Portrait. And you made that happen. It really.
What was that? The Truckee Town Portrait? I forgot what that was.
And I noticed it's not on your list, which was highly disappointing to me, but I don't think people understand.
For those of you out there, this was Maya's idea, the Truckee Town Portrait, who she caught me into helping with.
So. Well, it's a little arm-twisting.
It was a lot of fun. It was a neat event.
You really made that happen. But I'm looking over here, the dare auction, the Sunrise Rotary duck races, the crab feeds, the wildlife shelters, and then you've been awarded a number of awards, all of which have been very earned. Rotarian of the Year for the Truckee Rotary Club, Rotarian of the Year for the Sausalito Rotary Club. You've been named Truckee Citizen of the Year by the Truckee Donner Chamber of Commerce. You got to be the Grand Marshal in the parade. Why, Steve? Why do people recognize you like that?
That's a good question. No, I've been blessed, and it's been kind of neat. But, you know, you don't do these things for the awards. It's you do it. I do it because it makes me feel good. You know, the one thing is, when I do retire, I'm going to be able to say I've got my own personal bank account, and it's not going to be money. It's going to be all the smiles and the happiness that I brought to, you know, kids and adults and things like that. And that's what turns me on and makes me feel good.
Well, then I'm going to ask you the question you told me not to ask you, but I'm going to ask it anyway. What's the legacy you want to leave here? Is that it?
You know, I don't know. I mean, to be honest with you, I just want to keep doing good things in the community at this point, and whatever my legacy is, it'll be, you know. But I think that, you know, I would hope that people would think of Steve Randall as someone with integrity and someone that was there to do the job when it needed to be done, and, you know, really said, you know, had a vision of, you know, what do we need within this community, and tried to provide those types of things.
I remember at one point during the organization of the town portrait, and I was sort of pulling my hair out and frantic about things that may not get done. And you said to me, if I told you it's going to get done, it's going to get done. And I had to rely on your word for that. And by God, if everybody in town that I've spoken to hasn't said, if Steve Randall says it's going to get done, it's going to get done.
Well, thank you.
I think that's why you get recognized, Steve. You really do make things happen. And when you look around this community, I love nothing more on a warm summer night than to go out on one of the piers at Donner Lake and just watch the moon go over Schallenberger Ridge. And I couldn't do that if you hadn't made that happen. And I know that there are boards involved and employees involved, but I really see you as the mover and shaker.
Well, I think a lot of times I may be the vision man, but I have to give a lot of credit to my staff. I mean, I'm not one person. It's a group of people. I may be their leader, but I need all of them, and they have good vision and they have the ideas, and it works, you know, because this is a community and that's why it works.
Yeah. What are some of the challenges at Reckon Park?
I think at this point in time, probably our biggest challenge is to get a new community center. It's, if you want to go back to that legacy question, that's probably the one thing that I haven't accomplished at this point in time, to get that new community center. Right now, we're in the process of building a new field complex, and by August of 2003, we will have 5 new ball fields online. That's been one thing that's been difficult in this community, because we haven't had enough field space for all the activities and sports that we have. So we've been successful in doing that. I was successful in getting a $2 million loan from the state at next to nothing, at a 2.93%. We were the first and only park and rec agency in the state to get that kind of award at this point, so that's kind of neat. So anyway, these fields will be coming online in August of 2003, but our next thing is I want that community
that
center.
Rec center.
And the reason for that is because we're busting out of the seams. We can't do all the things that we'd like to do, and we need that bigger building. We need it for, you know, theater and, you know, the myriad of events that go on, not only with Parks and Rec, but also in the community.
There's a number of groups in the community that want to see a community center, a theater, a place to gather for events. And I imagine at some point these different groups will be converging on one another. There'll be a confluence of
We're working on it. It's not to say it's not happening. It's
right.
Just things don't always happen as fast as you want them, and I understand and realize how that works.
Steve Randall, if you're working on it, I have every faith in the world that it will happen.
Well, I think it'll happen eventually, but it's an expensive thing, so it's going to take some time.
Thank you so much for being on the show.
Well, thanks
it's
for having me.
It's been a pleasure being able to share a little bit more about you with the community.
Okay.
Next time we have you on, we'll ask the real in-depth questions. Again, we've been talking with Steve Randall, manager of the Truckee Donner Recreation and Park District, and we'll be back in just a minute with upcoming events. Stay tuned.